A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd April, on the front page you have Sri Lanka names local Islamist group for Easter Sunday blasts. So the terrorist attacks which we saw on Sunday, which happened in Sri Lanka, now the minister says that sophisticated attacks such as this points to wider international groups. Then this is the race heats up. So this is regarding the third phase of Lok Sabha elections, which will be held for 117 seats across the country. You can see the map showing them. Then below you have CJI violated procedure by hearing own case, Supreme Court lawyers. So this is regarding the sexual harassment charges which have been leveled against him and how he heard his own case and later accused himself from the bench. Then this is US ends waiver for India on Iran oil. So this is regarding exemptions which were granted to some countries by USA. US has imposed sanctions for Iran, Iranian products, but some countries were given waiver, 180 day period of exemption from sanctions, but this has also ended now. So US ends waiver for India. So this exemption sanctions actually allowed India import of oil, but now this is not possible. So that is it. On page 9 you have Indian Medical Association threatens agitation over bridge course proposal. So this is Niti Aayog's proposal to have a bridge course between Indian bachelor, between Bachelor of Dental Surgery, BDS and MBBS. So this will allow dentists to practice family medicine. So the Indian Medical Association is threatening nationwide agitation again if this proposal is taken forward. So, the Niti Aayog had earlier proposed a bridge course for Ayush and, allopathy. So this the was proposed in the National Medical Commission Bill, which was meant to replace the Indian Medical Council Act. But following proposed pressure from Indian Medical Association, that course was rejected. And now this is a bridge course between BDS and MBBS proposed. Then, this is Supreme Court seeks replies from Centre and Jammu and Kashmir on highway traffic ban. So state government has barred civilian traffic for 2 days a week. So now this case is before the Supreme Court. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Sunday Bloody Sunday regarding the Sri Lankan attacks. It says preventing further attacks and keeping the peace are vital in Sri Lanka. And the second editorial, Line of Caution. So this is regarding suspension of cross LOC trade. So the editorial says this will cause hardship to the people and it must be revoked. The lead article, Down to Earth on the Asset Test. So this says that India has neither achieved a higher level of deterrence nor enabled a more stable strategic security environment. So Asset Test was a big flaw, is what has been highlighted in this article, because it is not going to achieve deterrence because we don't need any such deterrence, because like China Pakistan, even if they have, Pakistan doesn't even have this technology. Plus also it is creating unevenness and more instability. So it did not achieve a more stable strategic security environment. And this is a half-written promise. So this is regarding how political parties must steer political debate to crucial issues relating to women's health and reproductive rights. Then this is on the opinion page, the court is not above the constitution. So this is regarding how a former junior court assistant at Supreme Court has sent sworn affidavits to 22 judges of Supreme Court regarding and alleging sexual harassment charges against the Chief Justice of India. So this actually is a case in which the CJI himself sat on the bench and heard and gave statements. So this article says that the court is not above the constitution. The expectation of citizens is that the Supreme Court will lead by example, not by arbitrary diktat. On international page you have India issued alert to Sri Lanka on possible blasts. So the Colombo mission, among the potential targets were mentioned by India as a precaution in after early April warning. So here you can see NIA, National Investigation Agency of India, had specific intelligence on these blasts in Sri Lanka. So it was examining an Islamic State sympathizer in Tamil Nadu 6 months ago, and they got to know of the terror plot, and they alerted the authorities concerned to pass on the information to Sri Lanka. Then on business page you have RBI to assess if India Bulls is fit and proper. So the RBI will closely examine the fit and proper criteria of India Bulls group founder and chairman Sameer Gehlot, because it is planning, India Bulls is planning to merge itself with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. So no, the thing is that Sameer Gehlot's name figures in Panama Papers, so this may impact the merger with LVBP. So we have to wait and watch. Panama Papers were these international papers in which names of prominent leaders and people associated with prominent leaders like prime ministers and presidents of various countries who had accounts here in Panama, which is a tax haven. This is there. And below you have GAIL emerges highest bidder for ILNFS wind assets portfolio. So this is regarding ILNFS. And for the wind portfolio, GAIL has emerged the highest bidder. It has offered 4,800 crore for 7 plants with 874 megawatt capacity. On the last page, you have Earth Day. Saving the planet may cost $100 billion per year. So scientists have proposed a policy to prevent another mass extinction event. So this will require at least $100 billion a year, is what the scientists say, who have proposed this policy. Here you can see a global deal for nature is what it is called. So there are 19 international authors who have proposed this new science policy to reverse the tide of mass extinction event. So what it will do is it will save the diversity and abundance of life on the earth, but then it will come with a price. Then this is climate change protesters chart a new course. So this is regarding climate change protest activists who have been protesting here, and so this is called Extinction Rebellion. So they have taken over London, the heart of UK capital, and to focus global attention on rising temperatures and sea levels caused by greenhouse gas emissions. And below you have scientists use EU satellite to spot Aegean sea litter. So this is regarding Aegean sea in Europe. So here to detect marine litter, satellites have been used. European Union satellites have been used. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and download the current affairs PDFs too, which are available by the end of the day. And also you can also look at prelims preparation keywords which are provided on the website. So that is it. Thank you.